Any question up to this? Okay, I will revise it very rapidly. Patient comes with acute osteomyelitis, right? You are strongly suspecting acute osteomyelitis. In very early stage, the best test is?
MRI.
Right? After 10 days or so, plain x-rays may show some changes. So by that time, acute is converting into chronic. So not great news. So MRI, number one, gold standard. Best way to culture. Take a piece of infected bone or infected bone marrow. Is it right for culture? Third thing, an acute osteomyelitis, when you are using antibiotic. Yes, what are the features of those antibiotics? They must be bactericidal. Then they should be able to penetrate bones. And then they should be able to cover the staphylococcus aureus. And if you suspect that patient is in that situation where MRSA is suspected, then that should be covered too. Is that right? Usually empirically we start with vancomycin or clindamycin. Both of them can cover staphylococcus aureus, which is methicillin resistant, right? Or if you are not suspecting methicillin resistant organism, you can go with other drugs like nephicillin or cephalexin, right? But once the report comes for the culture, according to that you will tailor the antibiotic. Right, then important thing to remember. Antibiotics, initially, usually in acute osteomyelitis, must be started parentally. That, this information, I was talking about chronic. In acute osteomyelitis, the antibiotic should be given parentally, and it should be given for a long time, 4 to 6 weeks. Is that right? But in acute osteomyelitis, if there's no response, or patient even keep on deteriorating, within 36 hours, up to 36 hours, don't wait much. You need to think that either your antibiotic is not okay, or some periosteal abscess has been formed, which if one abscess, you need to drain it. You are understanding?
Yes.
Secondly, if septic arthritis is suspecting, again, it's a serious issue in the management, during the management of acute, you need to talk to the orthopedic surgeon. Is that right? Or if you think the sequestrum is there, it means already when case came to you, it was late, right? Then you need to talk to the orthopedic surgeon. Am I clear? Then when you talk about the chronic osteomyelitis, it's one of the very, very bad and ugly infection. It's very difficult to eradicate, right? Sometimes for decades and decades, it keep on flaring up again and again, right? And in chronic case, for ultimate treatment, we have to do surgery. We have to remove the infected piece of bone. We need to remove the sequestrum. We need to debride a lot of tissue, right? And then we have to, maybe we need to, if bone becomes very deep, we have to put external splintage, support to the bone. And maybe that gap need to be filled with bone chips. Maybe you need to put some mechanism to vascularize that tissue which heals. It's really a tough job. And at the top, only good news is that now we are coming to know in chronic osteomyelitis, by susceptible organism to ciprofloxacin, cipro orally is as good as parenteral if it is given 8 weeks, right? And if you are, that is staphylococcus aureus, with cipro, you can add different things. Any question? Okay, class dismiss.